Here we continue on working with the Acura H6, a 6-speed automatic transmission. What we've done is carefully remove the bolts for the solenoid valve body assembly. We're going to set this to the side. Now, as we prepare to separate the case halves, obviously the first thing that we're going to have to do is remove these covers, and then we'll be removing these two nuts. One has right-hand threads, and the other one has left-hand threads. This one is going to be a 6.41 millimeter, and this is a 12.34 millimeter. The one with the left-hand threads will have an arrow denoting that this is left-hand thread. And of course, what that means is that if I want to remove the nut, I actually have to turn it clockwise. To install it counterclockwise, as the arrow indicates. This is just a conventional right-hand thread nut. We'll be using an impact to remove these, and of course, as we install it, we can start it with an impact. We would like to finish it there with a torque wrench. Now, in removing the bolts that hold the case halves together, there are a variety of different sizes, but you know that you have the bolt in the right place if it is a uniform height from the case. So that's just a quick rule of thumb when putting it back together. Just note, if I got bolts swapped, well, that's pretty obvious, isn't it? Here we're going to go ahead and use a 3/4 inch impact and our 41 millimeter 6-point socket. Remove this nut and this, of course, is right-hand thread. Now we're ready to remove the 34 millimeter. Note the arrow indicating that this is left-hand thread. Now we're ready to remove the two washers underneath the nuts. The X is going to note the up direction. Now these are actually a light press fit onto the shaft, and you're going to have to use a associated pry bar or screwdrivers to gently pick them up. And as you can see, the press fit is actually there in the splines. And again, the X denotes the up direction. Okay, here we're ready to separate the two case halves. Now, one thing that's extremely important is that we not damage the gasket surface. Under no circumstances should I be installing a screwdriver or pry bar between the case halves. This would damage the gasket surface and really create a problem for a long-term leak. Now, you'll notice that when you look at the design, it really does not have any suitable lift points there to try and lift the case halves apart. So one method is to simply hook up the chain. You notice that I have actually lifting points, and I'm actually going to use a lift to just lift the case halves apart. Now, as I do so, I've removed the nuts, and as I apply pressure, I've got to reach inside here and open the snap ring that's retaining this bearing into the case. Now, this case was especially hard to separate because, as we've seen before, this vehicle was in an accident, and the body shop used a aluminum wire feed MIG welder to do some strategic repairs on the case, and it actually looked pretty good. In fact, not only on the case, but also on the engine. Hard hit to the front. Unfortunately, when they were welding here, they actually undercut the bearing, and it was not allowing us to separate the case halves. So we actually had to grind it away, and then, of course, as we did so, it comes apart. Now, this transmission will become a core, and we've, of course, ordered another transmission from the automotive recycling facility, and that should do very nicely. It was very reasonably priced. Okay, now we're ready to go ahead and lift the case halves by supporting the upper portion of the case and installing some of the case halve bolts back. I can actually lift the case and gently tap to separate the case halves. Don't forget to go ahead and spread the snap ring to release this bearing, and the case should just slip right apart. Okay, after gently lifting the case, carefully spreading the snap ring, and a couple of strategic taps, boom, she comes right apart. We did not touch this surface whatsoever. Removing the two bolts, and I can just simply lift the case half apart. Now, the lift method of separating the case results in absolutely no contact with the gasket or the gasket surface. Now, with the case separated, one thing you want to be sensitive to is that this washer is going to want to stay with the bearing in the case, and oftentimes it, of course, will fall out when you separate the case. So be sure to pay attention to that and not lose it. Okay, at this point we're ready to continue disassembling the transmission. If we come around to this side slightly, we'll notice that the welding there at the body shop to repair the damage. And this was a potential leak area right here, but actually it was pretty good. It didn't leak, but as you can see that they welded it from the external to the, did not take apart the transmission. It was able to save the transmission and put the vehicle back on the road. As far as how long did it go? Probably 30, 40,000 miles before the flex plate actually broke, and the torque converter was moving back and forth in the front pump of the transmission. It was leaking fluid and making a lot of noise, and that's why it came to our shop. Now let's go ahead and we'll remove the filter, and we'll also remove the dam that's directing the fluid away from the gear train. Now, as I remove these bolts, some of these bolts will only be for retaining, like the filter and our oil dam. So they're not actually holding the valve body together. So I can go ahead and just put those bolts right back. That way I know where they came from. So let's go ahead and get started. First start by removing the filter. Okay, here we've removed the oil filter, and of course this is something that we'd want to replace in an overhaul. And you'll notice that the bolts retaining the filter I put right back. They're not going through the valve body or have anything to do with retaining the halves of the valve body. So that way, hey, I know exactly where they came from. Now, this is a lubrication channel that I'm going to be removing here. And again, this bolt does not go into the valve body, it's just for retaining this tube. There is no O-ring at this location, so I'm going to put that bolt right back. Okay, here we see the reverse servo piston and rod, and here we see the shift fork for reverse. And before I remove the oil dam, I'm going to have to go ahead and remove this bolt. Now, when installing, be sure and torque it correctly, and don't forget to fold over the locking tab. Okay, here we've removed the oil dam. There are three bolts holding it in. You'll notice that the darker color bolts are the output bolts, and the silver one is the one there towards the center. And two of these bolts definitely are going down through the valve body. And we'll be working on the valve body a little bit separately, so I'll go ahead and put those back just so I can keep everything together. I'm going to go ahead and leave the bolt out for the retaining of the oil dam because I'm going to be working in this area removing the gear train.